extraterrestrials and UFOs. To some of you, this might seem like kind of a ludicrous topic to talk about. And I get that. I understand that there are certain topics that people don't like to discuss, whether or not there is any validity to it or not. But this happens to be a topic which I consider myself to be at least somewhat versed in. Now, I'm not claiming to be any kind of expert or, I believe when it comes to any topic or subject matter, I don't really believe there are experts per se, but I do believe there are some people that have a little more knowledge of certain things than other people do. So, as far as for me, I will say that yes, I do believe that there is life elsewhere throughout the universe. And to clarify that, by life, I do mean complex life forms such as ourselves, similar to us, but also I believe there could be other forms of complex life, either human-like or perhaps even much more closely related to what we refer to as microorganisms or microbes or even viruses. And to me, that's never really seemed ridiculous. Because if you think of the universe as being a vast ocean, and you think about the oceans here on Earth and the fact that we've yet to completely explore every last inch of the ocean floor here on Earth, it makes sense that, you know, in terms of when you think of the universe along the same lines, we've really only explored like less than 1% of the universe, let alone of the space around the Earth. So, yeah. Again, obviously I know not everybody agrees with me. And then, of course, if you've been watching my channel for a while now, I'm sure you know that, you know, I don't expect people to agree with everything that I talk about. That's what makes life interesting, right? That we don't all believe in the same things, we don't all have the same opinions, but as long as we're able to find some kind of common ground, or, you know, even if that common ground is just agreeing to disagree, then there's nothing wrong with that. But getting back to when it comes to extraterrestrials and UFOs, like I said, I do believe that there are other advanced complex life forms out there in the universe besides us. At the same time, I am open to the possibility that there isn't any other complex life forms out there. But to me, that no longer seems like a very real possibility. But I'm still open to that possibility. Because one thing I like to make sure to remind myself of is to be open to any and all possibilities. But at the same time, I don't allow myself to get too carried away with one theory over another, or one opinion over another. You know, I mean, overall, and I'm sure I've explained in a number of my other videos, you know, I have a very much more zen outlook on life, and, you know, I prefer to just take each moment as it comes, live and live within each moment. That's important, to ground ourselves within each moment. And when it comes to topics such as extraterrestrial life or UFOs, which, by the way, UFO does stand for Unidentified Flying Object. And of course, this can be applied to any kind of unknown or unfamiliar aircraft that we see in the sky. That is technically, I mean, when we see some kind of aircraft flying around in the sky, and we know it's not a plane, it's not a helicopter, not a balloon, or any other known aircraft, then it is technically a UFO, unidentified flying object. So, and in fact, one of the things I wanted to talk about a little bit, maybe not so in-depth, but here where I live, El Paso, Texas, we have had our fair share of interesting, very interesting UFO sightings. And of course, when I say UFO, again, I mean just that unidentified flying object. I'm not saying that I know for a fact that when it comes to these particular sightings that they were of extraterrestrial origin, but I'm also not saying that I know for a fact that they were of any kind of top secret military project. Rather, I guess, you know, again, I'm saying that I'm open to that possibility that it could be either or none of the above. But for example, August of 2015, there was a very interesting UFO sighting that occurred here in El Paso. I want to say it started off like in the northeast side of town, and then kind of moved towards the far east side of town. But it was these orbs of light that just suddenly appeared and just kind of hovered around in a particular area for, I'm not sure how long, maybe a period of, I want to say maybe 15, 20, no more than 30 minutes, I believe. There was a lot of people that took video footage of it. It was reported on in the news, but then unfortunately, of course, the mainstream news, they brushed it off as being nothing more than some kind of military exercise, something like that. They tried to say that it was nothing more than flares, but I can tell you right now, there's no way that they were flares, because if they were, then they were, you know, extremely intelligent flares, because some of the maneuvers they performed in the air, you know, they did all these complex patterns in the air and just hovered for a couple of minutes at a time and then switched position, hovered again for another couple of minutes, switched position again. So, I don't know of any flares that can do that. I do not know. And also, too, they made absolutely no sound. They emitted no sound. So they definitely weren't planes, definitely weren't helicopters. But I mean, obviously I know some people who try to explain something like that, they tend to, if they don't know what it is, and at the same time, if they're not able to process the reality of what it might actually be, then they prefer to just brush it off, explain it away as something very simple, like flares, or weather balloons, or swamp gas, or I don't know, some other kind of top secret military project. Or, but I will say, if they were flares, again, yeah, they were highly intelligent flares. And if that's the case, you know, I was still, at the time when it occurred during the sighting, the next day, I mean, I posed a lot of questions online and to some of my friends who are in the military, you know. I told them, I said, if these were a part of some kind of secret, top secret military project, why the hell did they do it over such a densely populated area? If that was their way of just trying to share some form of new technology with the public, then hey, yeah, I kind of get that. But at the same time, why don't they just make some kind of formal announcement to share this technology with the public? Tell them, we've got these aircraft or whatever they were. I don't know. I don't believe they were flares. I don't know why they were flares, but. But yeah, I mean, at the very least, they could have made some kind of formal announcement to the public, telling them, we have access to this kind of technology, this form of technology that allows us to operate aircraft without the need for fossil fuels. Because that's definitely what it seemed like, if they were some kind of top secret aircraft or drones or whatever, they emitted no sound. They were able to hover, again, like I said, for minutes at a time. They were able to hover for a total of over 30 minutes. But then at the same time, when they stopped, they didn't land. It definitely didn't look like they made any kind of traditional landing, like an airplane or helicopter. They just eventually disappeared. Or faded out, or I don't know, maybe they diminished their source of light somehow. anyways, and I'm not saying that I know exactly what they were. I'm just explaining. I'm trying to recall, exactly what I saw and what a lot of other people here in El Paso saw on that night back in August 2015. To this day, it still remains unexplained. And there have been several other similar sightings since then. Nothing on the same scale, but still just as interesting. And I also know that there have been, again, other similar sightings worldwide, which there is footage of on YouTube. So because of that, ever since then, I did start a Facebook page, which I call UFOs Are Awesome. Anything and everything UFO related, I post on that Facebook page. I'll provide a link down below if you want to check it out, because there is a lot of information when it comes to this kind of subject matter. I believe people should be informed. I mean, we should all be informed about many different things. But again, we should take it all with a grain of salt. Don't believe something just because somebody's telling us to believe in it. We got to decide for ourselves, ultimately. So, yeah. I better end this right now because I don't want to ramble on too much, but surprised I kind of did. So, thanks for watching. That'll do it, I guess, for Vlogmas day 18. 18, yeah. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Thank you, everybody, who's currently subscribed. I do appreciate it. Until next time, keep it real. Keep on rocking. Peace.